What did the Collectors gain by turning humans into this Reaper shell?
They may be facilitating the Reaper equivalent of reproduction. Or it may serve another purpose. I do not have the data to speculate further. However, it is clear that the Collectors are merely pawns. The technology and ability needed to create this Reaper is not their own. It is likely that different species construct each Reaper. In this case, the Collectors provide the labor.
Protheans.
The Collectors are just Protheans. Why would they help the Reapers?
The Reapers subdued the Protheans long ago. Probabilities suggest they attempted to create a Prothean Reaper and failed. Over time, they adapted the Protheans to suit their needs, changed them, turned them into workers, tools for the Reapers.
Take her down.
It's too big for our guns. Edie, find me a way to blow this thing to hell.
The large tubes injecting the fluid are a weak structural link. Destroying them should cause the supports to collapse and the Reaper to fall.
Give us a minute, Edie. We gotta take care of some old friends first.
Hostile targets.
Of course not, man.
Assuming control.
Getting water across. Affirmative.
Ground team, status report.
Jack here. I'm tagging them as they come. But feel free to call for an exit at any time.
Head to the Normandy. Joker, prep the engines. I'm about to overload this place and blow it sky high.
Roger that, Commander.
What's it?
Commander, I've got an incoming signal from the Elusive Man. He's patching it through.
Shepard. You've done the impossible.
Is that it? I mean, I thought I fought the robot or something. And just get started.
I'm not finished here yet. This base is 10 minutes from extinction.
Yeah. Wait. I have a better option. I'm looking at the schematics Edie uploaded. Okay. A timed radiation pulse would kill the remaining collectors, but leave the machinery and technology intact. This is our chance, Shepard. They were building a Reaper. That knowledge, that framework, could save us.
This place is abomination.
It liquefied people, turned them into something horrible. We have to destroy the base.
Don't be short-sighted.
I wanted the Paragon.
Our best chance against the Reapers is to turn their own resources against them.
Mm. Agreed. Collector base horrific, vile experiments, but should use what's here. Risks galaxy to ignore opportunity.
He's right, Shepard. Yeah. They were working directly with the collectors. Who knows what information is buried there? This base is a gift. We can't just destroy it.
You're completely ruthless. The next thing I know, you'll be wanting to grow your own Reaper.
My goal is to save humanity from the Reapers, at any cost. I've never hidden that from you. Imagine how many lives could be saved if we keep this base intact and use its knowledge to thwart the Reapers. Imagine the lives that will be lost if we don't.
Let's do the middle one for now.
Our mission was to destroy the base.
Shepard, you died fighting for what you believed. I brought you back so you could keep fighting. Some would say what we did to you was going too far, but look what you've accomplished. I didn't discard you because I knew your value. Don't be so quick to discard this facility. Think of the potential.
I should just... Never.
Fear compromise who I am.
I guess once you know to
Shepard,
shoot the tubes.
Think about what's at stake, about everything Cerberus has done for you. You...
cut off. I thought I was gonna have to fight the big robot, and I guess not.
Let's move. We've got 10 minutes before the reactor overloads and blows this whole station apart.
I guess Luke gets fun. Oh, shit. I like the sniper rifle, it's a better choice.
Rerouting power to shield.
Shot. Right.
Positive scene action.
Wish I was dead,
Gilbert!
Harbinger.
Team make it.
Yeah.
All survivors on board. We're just waiting for you.
Human, you've changed.
Oh, shit.
Your species has the attention of those infinitely or greater.
Get the fuck out of here.
That which you know as Reapers are your salvation through destruction.
Say it. How does it do Mass Effect though at the end? There's no relay, so I don't. Not too sure about that. And every other clip when they go fast like that, they hit the relay. That part they just went light speed right at the end. Oh, damn! Ship's fucked up.
Shepard, you're making a habit of costing me more than time and money.
Oh damn, it's got blue sun. What does that mean? Hoover. Let's be asshole.
I'm sorry, I'm having trouble hearing you. I'm getting a lot of bullshit on this line.
Don't try my patience. The technology from that base could have secured human dominance in the galaxy, against the Reapers and beyond.
Human dominance, or just Cerberus?
Strength for Cerberus is strength for every human. Cerberus is humanity.
Sure.
I should have known you'd choke on the hard decisions. Too idealistic from the start.
Yeah. Don't lecture me.
I'm not looking for your approval. Harbinger is coming, and he won't be alone. Humanity needs a leader who's looking out for them.
Also, Harbinger wasn't even on that ship.
Way, whether you agree or not.
I don't know.
Don't turn your back on me, Shepard. I made you. I brought you back from the dead.
Gosh. What down the shit, huh?
Joker, lose this chin.
Chair looks uncomfortable. Look at that. That's an awesome star. It's like a white star. Everybody's allowed. Only seen like six guys. Oh shit, look at this. We're fucked. Yeah, what I wanna say. Then one heck of a playthrough, guys. Yeah. Ready for Mass Effect 3 now. The ending's pretty cool though. I do gotta say, like, I like the first game a lot better than the second game. You know, it's hard to compare it to. This game, I guess, sort of feels more like Gears and stuff. Still pretty fun. I've enjoyed this. That's the art animation. So yeah, I guess the plus stuff of this game is, you know, they reduced the mineral finding. Took out the ship and stuff. I don't know, when you look at the screen like you do with the scanners, it's not really much better, so. Let's see how it pans out in Mass Effect 3. So yeah, it's one heck of a playthrough. Alright, so what else do I want to do? Yeah, I think everybody's alive in my playthrough. Again, the goal of, this playthrough I did was get thrown in the sand to keep all my team members alive. So far it looks like that happened, but who said it? How I did it this time. I got Mordorith. It's like the evil Samara. It's like a super evil movie there too. So. I'd like to see what she does in the next game. But. I romance Tally. I probably romance a few other characters after her. Yeah. One last thing, you notice the credits here. The first game when you beat it, you had an awesome badass techno song. This is just like ambient music, ambient or whatever. I actually forgot what it was called, but yeah, the credits here with There's no badass song then. Did sort of disappoint me. It's sort of generic music here. I don't know how this game's alright. It's just, you know, man, first game is starting to show its age some. And I hope maybe one day they might be able to remake all three of these with, maybe for the new console and show off the new technology and stuff. But, you know, hopefully it won't be like a lot of these remakes where they just upscale the graphics and they try to probably redo the engine or something. I guess last thing is, I guess I'll touch on my YouTube channel. Not sure I'm gonna play next after this. Probably finish up Kingdoms of Amalur. I haven't beaten that yet. Not sure where I got planned out from here. I'm still new. Yeah. It's probably like my first halfway played game. I didn't get a chance to get the first part recorded because I wasn't really too much in video recording for that. So hopefully, I'll be able to do a full game somewhere. Get the whole playthrough. I'm in there. So, guess a few improvements I can see in the next game is you're the damn planet, so put more aside. Quest and it's easy to find. Make them fun to do, just like a mission. They don't have stuff where it's just extra stuff to find a world mission. Make its own mission and shoot guys and stuff. That type of stuff. I'd like to see maybe more of the first game where you just go and plant, it feels open world. Miss the big ship. And I guess the last thing I touched on is the overall tone and darkness of the game. Second game, you know, felt, I guess, a little like John Cena, where a lot of the choices and stuff felt like it didn't really matter. I mean, you could take it seriously, but first game, I mean, felt really dark. And I hope maybe in the third game that'll improve some, so. I guess I'll end it here. Again, thanks for watching. It's been one heck of a playthrough to get ready for Mass Effect 3. Hopefully I got all the characters ready and move on. I'll probably end it here, but I'm going to do like a check and make sure everybody's alive after these credits. Anyways, peace, guys. I'm out. Firewalker, it's like the most worthless mission. Yeah, I'll just keep it going. I'm not gonna talk too much about credits. That's fine. Design, cinema designers. I don't know how long this is. Quality. Yeah. A live Q&A there. Cast. I guess DLC or something. Oh, okay, I get me. I'm putting the credits for like each DLC. I don't know. Man, it's gonna take forever. Special thanks. It's long cast at Overlord. I like that DLC, by the way. I think this game really didn't have enough Geth in it. I mean, a lot of the NPCs were a little generic too, so. The first few levels, I mean, they had like chargers, they had wolves, stuff like that. But I don't know, I mean, I guess that's get one last point again, even though I said I'm done. I hope maybe they have a little more variety of NPCs, put more flamethrowers in, and just don't have like everybody ducking and shooting. Yeah, the Harbingers are pretty good at the end there. Hopefully, it won't just be like a lot of generic guys with shields and stuff, and you got some shotgunners and stuff like that. Alright. Anyways, let's get on with the crits. Probably have another DLC here too. Oh, and Shatterbreaker. I like that one too. Sadly, my playthrough didn't show up. It's pretty fun. Huh? I'd say about any DLC is worth it, except maybe the Fire. Firestarter or something. Yeah, Firewalker. Skip that one if you don't have the network or whatever. But yeah, the Arrival and all those are good. By the way, I think Arrival's gonna be changed like the start of the game pretty drastically compared to what the demo was. But we'll see. This keeps on going, does it? Production. All you see is production program. Don't even know what DLC is on here. Ah, shit. Let's keep it going. That's probably it, though. Yeah. Tell you what, I'm gonna. I think you get the option to keep playing, so. I just do keep playing. I'm not sure if that'll affect the save or not. All right, let's read this real quick. I'm not going to do import. Let's continue. And my fishies are still there. Let's get that save in. Most important thing is see if I get everybody alive. Heard like Kelly does like a strip tease to him. It's even better than.
You came for us.
Hey.
I knew you would. Thank you. 1,000 times, thank you.
That's comfort.
How are you doing, Kelly?
I'm holding up.
Yeah.
Can't get the memories out of my head. Trapped.
Oh shit.
Suffocating. It's oozing into every pore. Faint sobs echoing the confined space.
Nasty.
But I can't dwell on it.
Nasty.
I'm okay now. I'm alive. Back to the old Kelly.
Back to the old Kelly.
Do you have a moment to talk?
I always have time for you, Commander.
Damn it, I guess I can't do the striptease with.
I better go.
Okay. Maybe we'll talk later.
Okay. Oh, I guess I'll get the romance kill here. Jacob's though.
Didn't expect you to light up that base, Shepard. Hell of a way to tell the boss you're quitting. I wish I could have seen his face. It's not over, though.
It's fucked, dude.
Bad guys on the horizon. And now Cerberus wants your tail.
Yeah,
boring, huh? I don't know what kind of time we have, but we better dust off and stay ready.
Yes, you
sure as hell know how to make enemies.
Okay. We'll talk later.
Commander,